We have to know what we're looking for. This being the case, we are at the bottom of a gravitational well. The heavens are higher than the earth. Out beyond this, higher in the gravitational well, laboratory experiments have determined on planet Earth that the higher you get in elevation, the more rapidly time runs. Meaning that in our galaxy, time is on our frame. Near to us, time is still very recent. But as the fabric of space was stretched by the Creator, according to Isaiah 40, Psalm 104, verse 2, Psalm 18 and 2 Samuel 22, as the Creator stretched the fabric of space, in distant galaxies, time ran faster. Galaxies matured faster, all within the last few thousand years. We're at the gravitational well, where time runs on the normal clock. Beyond this, higher in elevation, for the heavens are higher than the earth, God's ways are higher than our ways, and His thoughts than our thoughts. In these heavens, with the stretching of space fabric, time runs on a faster clock. And again, all of this having been created within the last few, we prefer to think, 6,000 years. That being the case, watch very closely. This is exciting. Supernova shell shock echoes distant or recent creation. As reported by David Kopage of the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, supernova remnants, SNRs, are shells of material expanding outward from stellar explosions, and you see some of that as photographed by NASA. A pulsar thought to be 24,000 years old was photographed by the Chandra telescope in 2003. It was thought to be 24,000 years old. It was relatively close to our Milky Way galaxy. Astronomers later realized that it lined up with a supernova observed by the Chinese in 8386. Wait a minute. It's less than 2,000 years old. Yet assigned an age of 24,000 years, that means that in the near heavens, things are running on our clock. Let's continue this. Light echoes from two ancient supernova remnants in the large Magellanic Cloud were recently reported to be merely 410 and 610 years old. Did you get this? This is astounding. Again, consistent with the creation model, we're at the center of the universe. Our entire galaxy is at the center of the universe. Everything else is expanding from us. But the evolutionary community does not want to admit that planet Earth, our galaxy, man, are anything special at all. We're just the average of what's going on in the universe. Not so. In our gravitational well, time runs more slowly. At the higher elevations, time runs more rapidly. But here we have, in the large Magellanic Cloud, a beautiful remnant of explosion that supposedly was very ancient, tens to hundreds of thousands of years old, turns out to be only 410 and 610 years old. This is consistent with the creation model. Let's take it a step beyond. In the case of RCW 86 in Centaurus, the calculated time of the explosion, and here we have it, calculated time was 10,000 years. Astronomers now realize it was witnessed by Chinese astronomers just 1,821 years ago. Wow! Expansion of the space fabric, as I've described, accounts for the larger deep time and deep space events, all within a recent time work of a few thousand years. This time frame demonstrates that the heavens verify recent creation. Now, as we close the broadcast today, it's very obvious that we're being schooled not only within the classroom where the student has more waking time, more conscious time, more communication time with the educational system. Teachers are very important. More time with the educational system than all the waking conscious time they spend with their parents or their siblings. And in this educational system, and I'm for the educational system, I lecture in the educational system as often as time permits, but in this system, we're being deprived, our students are being deprived of the actual facts that evidence points to the framework of a recent creation within what was interpreted to be tens or hundreds of thousands of years, and with a stretching of space fabric which must be accounted for, we have the deep time and deep space all covered within the framework of a few thousand years. This is better science than the science of evolutionary, stellar, long ages for the beginning of the universe. Evidence points to the fact that living systems were designed. Now we see that evidence points to the fact that the entire orchestrated background supporting those living systems is not only designed, but it's all within a recent time frame. Since that's the case, there is a creator. We must give an account to that creator. And since that's the case, since we must give an account, the Creator made it possible for us to give an account blamelessly. How do you do that? Well, His Son came, walked our streets, died for us on Calvary, shed His blood for us, His pure, perfect blood, having fulfilled every last jot and tittle of the law and human morality. He died for us. His blood was spotless. He was buried. He rose again. Now He's alive, wanting to apply the merits of His character and His blood to you. Would you pray this simple prayer? Just pray this prayer with me. Dear God, I know I'm a sinner. I now receive Jesus Christ this moment. Lord Jesus, come in. Apply Your morality and Your blood to my state of sin and to me personally. I receive You as my Savior. I'll serve You with all my heart.
Creation in the 21st Century has been sponsored by Trinity Broadcasting Network. And only with your love gift of support can this program stay on the air. So write to Creation in the 21st Century, P.O. Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711.
Creation in the 21st Century is a unique program on TBN combining biblical knowledge with scientific verification. Much of the information that I use on the program is available. Contact us. Just write Creation Evidence Museum, P.O. Box 309, Glen Rose, Texas 76043, or call us at 254-897-3200. We look forward to hearing from you today.